Good morning, students. Today we will discuss about lesson 3, geography, components of agriculture. Introduction. Soil is one of the most important natural resources. India's varied natural environments resulted in a great variety of soils. The rich, deep, fertile soil supports agriculture prosperity, which refers soil supports all agriculture activity. Soils. Soil is the uppermost layer of the land surface, usually composed of minerals, organic matters, living organism, air and water. Soil can vary from one region to other region. Now we will move to next topic, types of soil. The Indian Council of Agriculture Research, ICAR, set up in 1953, and ICAR divides the soils of India into 8 major groups. They are alluvial soil, black soils, red soils, laterite soils, forest and mountain soils, arid and desert soils, saline soils, peaty and marshy soils. Now we will discuss about formation of alluvial soil. Sediments, which is deposited by streams and rivers. Alluvial soil we found in the area of Ganga and Brahmaputra river valleys, Uttar Pradesh, Uttaranchal, Punjab, Haryana, West Bengal and Bihar. Crops which are suitable for alluvial soil: rice, wheat, sugarcane and oil seeds. Now we will discuss about black soil. Formation of black soil. It derived from basalt of Tekkan trap. Black soils we found the areas of Maharashtra, Kathiawar, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh and north part of Karnataka. Crops which are well grown in black soils are cotton, millets, tobacco and sugarcane. Now we will discuss about formation of red soil. Decomposition of ancient crystalline rocks like granite and gneisses. Gneisses refers a metamorphic rock. Red soil, which are found in the areas of eastern parts of Deccan Plateau, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Chota Nagpur Plateau. Crops which are grown in red soil are wheat, rice, cotton, sugarcane and pulses. Now we will discuss about formation of laterite soil. Formed in the region where alternate wet and hot dry condition prevail. Red soils are found in the areas of Assam Hills, Kerala, Karnataka, Eastern Ghats and region of Odisha. Crops which are well grown in laterite soil: coffee, rubber, cashew nut and tobacco. Next, we will discuss about forest and mountain soils. Formation of forest and mountain soils. Due to mechanical weathering caused by snow, rain and temperature variation. Distribution area of forest and mountain soils. Coniferous forest belt of Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand and Sikkim, eastern and western ghats. Crops which are grown well in forest and mountain soils are coffee, tea, rice, maize, potato, barley, tropical fruits and various type of spices. Now we will move to arid and desert soils. Formation of arid and desert soils. Due to prevalence of the dry climate, high temperature and high evaporation, the soil is dry. Distribution of arid and desert soils are Rajasthan, northern Gujarat and southern Punjab. Crops which are suitable for arid and desert soils are millets, barley, cotton, maize and pulses. Next we will move to saline and alkaline soils. Formation of saline and alkaline soils. It formed due to ill drainage which caused water logging. Distribution areas of saline and alkaline soils: Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan and Maharashtra. The next type of soil is peaty and marshy soils. Formation of peaty and marshy soils. Formed in humid regions from the organic matter. Distribution of peaty and marshy soils. Kottayam, Alappuzha district of Kerala, Odisha, Tamil Nadu, West Bengal, Bihar and Uttarakhand. Crops which are suitable in peaty and marshy soils are paddy and jute. Soil degradation. Soil degradation is an acute problem in India. According to a 2015 report of the Indian Institute of Remote Sensing, IIRS, the estimated amount of soil erosion that occurred in India was 147 million hectares. The main problem of Indian soils are soil erosion, degradation of soil, water logging, saline and alkaline, salt floods. Methods of conservation and management of soils: afforestation, construction dams, prevention of overgrazing, improved method of agriculture practices like rotation of crops, strip cropping, planting of shelter belts, adapting the techniques of sustainable agriculture or different conservation methods for better soil management. Irrigation. Watering of agricultural plants through artificial means is called irrigation. India is the hot country with the seasonal and irregular rainfall. It always needs irrigation to carry out of agriculture. Sources of irrigation. In India, different sources of irrigation are used depending upon the topography of soil, rainfall, availability of surface or groundwater, and nature of river. The main sources of irrigation are canal irrigation, well irrigation and tank irrigation. Inundation canals. In this, water is taken out directly from the rivers. The next one is perennial canals. These are developed from perennial river by constructing barrage to regulate the flow of water. Perennial refers do not dry. Well irrigation. A well is a hole. Usually this is vertical type, excavated in the earth for bringing groundwater to the surface. The well irrigation also divided into two categories. One is open wells. Another one is tube wells. Open wells. This type of irrigation is widely practiced in the areas where groundwater is sufficiently available. The next one, tube wells. Tube wells are developed in the areas of low water table with sufficient power supply. Last type of irrigation is tank irrigation. A tank is a natural or man-made hollow on the surface developed by constructing a small bunds around it across a stream. The tank irrigation is popular in the peninsular India due to some other reasons. They are natural depression serve as a reservoirs. Absence of perennial rivers. The scattered nature of population and agriculture fields. Modern irrigation methods. There are many ways in modern irrigation. Among them, mostly practiced and following in India are using drips, sprinklers and polyhouses, central pivot irrigations, multi-purpose river valley projects. Construction of dam across the river is aimed at many purposes. The various purpose of dam serves are irrigation, hydropower generation, water supply for drinking, and industrial purpose, controlling of floods, development of fisheries, navigation, etc. Okay students, the next part of this lesson will be uploaded soon.